addresses through the Strategic Housing Partnership about site development opportunities. We have a number of designated areas in Wirral that are called housing zones, where we bring some specific focus to many of the brownfield sites within the context of that. So, please, in terms of your question, the developers from various sectors, they have all of this information already, and we make it accessible and available to them, because what we want to do is try and work with them constructively to get as much residential development built that's appropriate to meet our housing needs on the appropriate sites.
Okay, thank you. I'm just going to take one final question, if that's okay.
And I'll come back on
that. Oh, but it's just funny to you.
Obviously, some of them are only one and two, three houses on a piece of land. So obviously, no major development is going on. So that's, you know, they're not going to know. We need to find the people that, you know, do just do these tiny developments.
I think it's fair to say that there are small housing associations who've got targets to grow from the HCIM, so they would be looking at just maybe doing one, two, three. So besides that, you know, you've got small housing associations who might be interested. Okay, the final question I'm going to take now is Stuart.
It was just to come back, you know, on the question. I appreciate that the committee refused well. Like, however, it was recommended for approval by officers. My criticism was more, it has to be said, of officers. Hoyle Police Station is also on the list, and that was approved for. Like, my point is this, and it might be something to take away. We go out of our way to defend the green belts. Yeah, because we want it to be kept as green belt. What we don't appear to do is go out of our way to protect land designated for housing. And that's the issue. I mean, it might not be defendable, I don't know until you try, but if we had refused something on the basis that our aspiration actually for that site wasn't commercial, it was residential, and we need the 12, for example, at Hoyle to meet our housing requirements. What are the inspector making this? I don't know. Sometimes I don't care. So long as I think I'm doing the right thing in attempting to put residential development in areas that are currently allocated by the UDP or the Coast Strategy for residential use. And, you know, that's the point that I was trying to make. Why are we giving away residential land, potential residential land for other non-residential uses? That's the point.
Thanks for your comments, Stuart. You know, as we've heard from David, there's a strong demand for housing in the region. So. Okay, we've been asked to note this report, so are we happy to note that?
Yeah.
I would just like to thank officers for the information that people have brought forward this evening.
Chair, just like that, thank you for your comments. Could we have a regular update on that, maybe every few months, on the numbers?
Yes, we're happy to provide that to us in the live figure.
Okay, thank you. We can move now to agenda item 15, please. Will we happen to note that report? Okay, agenda item 15, five applications decided on the delegated powers between the 9th of October and the 6th of November. Are we happy to note those?
Yes.
Thank you. And lastly, we have Daniel to back in the hot season. The board to call judicial review of the vote, please.
Yes, this is just very quick. The text is in at the end of the agenda papers that you've got. So we've now been notified by the court that the judicial review from Thornton Hall Hotel in relation to the recently granted of the Planning Commission at Thornton Manor will take place on the 31st of January of next year, and that will be held at the courts in Manchester. And I was asked a question at the last Planning Committee that following the recent refusal of a planning application to build our hotel, would we be progressing expeditiously with looking at enforcement options? And the answer to that question is Yes, we are, and we're considering those at the moment. I have meetings out there this afternoon on those particular matters. So I can just assure members that we are progressing and looking at all of those options. And obviously, we'll keep you advised of that. There's a number of legalities and technicalities that we need to look at and consider as part of that.
Is there any time scale on that day? Because obviously I'm getting a lot of pressure, as you are, from it to pass out. Have you got any time scale on the Ilmar enforcement process?
What I can say to you on that is that we are doing things very quickly and looking at all the options. There's a number of elements to it, and there are complexities that need to be fully considered. So we're trying to get to a point where we understand all of those things as quickly as we can. Then obviously we'll relay that through to members in due course.
Thank you.
Okay, I'd just like to thank officers for their cooperation tonight and members for their attendance.